Philippine Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri standing by his earlier pronouncement China had blacklisted Manila as a tourist destination due to continued offshore gaming operations in the country. This even after the Chinese embassy branded his statement misinformation. Zubiri insists Chinese Ambassador Wang Xilian mentioned blacklisting during their meeting, adding Senator Sherwin Gatchalian and Robin Padilla can vouch for him. He also blames the Chinese envoy for the miscue, saying he would seek a clarification from him.
The fault lies with the ambassador. He mentioned blacklisting. Siguro, nagkamali yung ambassador. The best way of saying is maybe mali po sa pagsabi ng misinformation. I think it should have just been a clarification. Kasi a clarification would mean clarify what the ambassador had said. But misinformation, lumalabas na para akong Marites na nagbibigay ng maling information or tinatawag nga na anong tawag dyan, yung fake news.
As for Malacanang, it welcomes the Chinese embassy statement.
We share the sentiment of the Chinese embassy in the Philippines that tourism is an important facet to our relationship. And we look forward to continuing with that relationship as we continuously welcome our friends from China, and we anticipate more of them to come in the months and years ahead.
The Foreign Affairs Department, meanwhile, says it is not aware of any tourism blacklist notice from China.
The Philippine Labor Department braces for a potential massive layoff of Filipino workers from offshore gaming companies in the country. The agency says it will provide assistance to over 23,000 Filipinos employed in the controversial gambling industry. The contingency measures include unemployment insurance and a retooling program to help the affected workers find new jobs. The Labor Department's plan comes in a growing calls for the Philippine government to ban offshore gaming in the country. Thousands of workers in the Philippine garment sector could be laid off in the coming months if demand for their products overseas remains weak. The Confederation of Wearable Exporters of the Philippines also warns of temporary closures of factories amid weak U.S. demand. The U.S. is the biggest market for apparel produced here in the Philippines. But companies there have deferred or canceled orders in recent months, with some now sourcing their supplies from Vietnam, Cambodia, and Indonesia due to lower labor costs. The group says several companies in Cebu have already laid off around 4,000 workers. Some factories in Batangas and Bataan also closed temporarily last month. An infectious diseases expert, Dr. Rogin Solante, says data regarding the COVID situation in the Philippines show the country is nearing the endemic stage. Solante says new cases at home have been on a downward trend and most infections are only mild. He adds even hospital admissions have become stable.
Yun ang ibig sabihin ng pandemic. Mataas ang mga kaso, mataas ang nagpupunta sa hospital. So ngayon, at that level, hindi na natin nakikita ito. In fact, a lot of countries are already opening the borders. A lot of countries are already increasing the mobility of people. Nandun na sa mga, may mga concert na, may mga gatherings na. And that is not the picture of a pandemic. Mm-hmm. Parang ano na lang yan, endemic lang.
Minutes from the Federal Reserve's September meeting show, policymakers were more worried about doing too little to control inflation than doing too much. They say inflation in the U.S. remains unacceptably high and cited reasons that it could keep it elevated for longer. These include rising labor tensions, a new round of global energy price increases, further disruptions in supply chains, and wage hikes. Given that outlook, Fed officials agreed it was critical to stick with their efforts to slow the economy and clamp down on inflation. The Fed has lifted its benchmark interest rate 5 times this year, including 75 basis point increases at each of their last 3 meetings.